with Dr. Greta, brought to you by the Ashley Clinic in Chanute, Kansas. Pop, pop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a. Well, you thought I was going to talk about that stomach thing, but no, I'm talking about firework injuries and the fact that some fireworks don't go off. They fizz or fizzle out, and those are the ones that can cause some serious damage, according to CPSC, Consumer Product Safety Commission. Interesting stuff there, and I recommend anybody who's got kids is to get on the internet and look about firework injuries as your kids change from year to year. So what was appropriate last year may not be now. But getting back to the pop, pop, fizz thing, it's always a good idea to have a bucket of water and a garden hose handy and be sure that the kids are supervised. That's probably more important than anything else. So what kind of things can your kids do for the fireworks? Can they do the sparklers or the firecrackers? After all, those sound like they shouldn't be a big deal. Well, sparklers get up to 1,000 degrees temperature, and those firecrackers can cause eye injury and hearing loss. So it is so important that your kids are supervised. But who gets injured with all of this? Well, according to this CPSC report, the highest injury group were 25 to 44-year-olds. So that's our parents. So our parents need to be extra careful, too. So the important thing is be sure that you are supervising kids. Be sure you have rules ahead of time as to what is going to be allowed or not allowed and how you're going to be sure that your kid is safe. Always be sure you look at the environment. Is the wind blowing a lot? Do you have anything that could catch fire? And be sure, again, you have that bucket of water and a plan. So give that kid a hug and have fun with the 4th of July. I'm Dr. Greta.